Goedemorgen, good morning, Dumelang, Mulweni. Geliefdes, het is vanmorgen voor mij een groot voorrecht om vanmorgen weer online tot u te komen. Prijs de Heer, ik is pastoor Rodney Nissen van Kerk van God in Caledon. And I am so honored and I'm so privileged this morning to speak to you out of the word of the Lord. Let's close our eyes for a moment. Heavenly Father, I thank you for the honor and for the privilege that I can avail of myself, Lord, in this hour of need, in this hour, difficult times in the world, in this moment, Lord. And we are trusting you for a word, and we believe that your word is the difference in our generation. Bless this word this morning that you've given, Lord, and I pray that you will use my tongue for your glory and for your purpose. In the name of Jesus, amen. Geliefdes, dit is vanmorgen voor mij een groot voorrecht. Dit is, prijs die Heere, December maand. Ons is, prijs die Heere, so 12, 13 dagen voor Kersfeest. En ons geloof en ons vertrouw dat die Heere voor ons machtig gaan deerdra. Wat een jaar het ons deurgegaan. Wat een moeilijke paar maanden het ons deurgegaan. Families, vrienden, prijs die Heere, gemeenskap, ons dorp wat geraak is deur die COVID-19. En hierdie jaar is een onvergetelijke jaar in ons almalse levens. En ons geloof te midden van een krom en een verdraaide geslag, en die Heere nog steeds sy kerk sy lig laat skyn. En ek geloof vanmorgen dat die Heere sy woord tot ons harte gaan seën. Ek lees vanmorgen vir u in die boek van Jesaja. I'm going to read out of the book of Isaiah chapter 61. Praise the name of Jesus. And if I might may title this word this morning, I do believe that God is about to change all our ashes into beauty. I do believe that God is about to do something miraculous in our time. Praise the Lord. God is going to change all this mess, praise the Lord, into a beautiful message. And I do believe that God is going to bless us this morning. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 61 and from verse 1, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor. Praise the name of Jesus. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to console those who mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes. Praise the Lord. The oil of joy for mourning. Praise the name of Jesus. The garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Praise the name of Jesus. That they may be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that He may be glorified. Geliefde kinders van die Heere, ek lees vir die Afrikaans gedeelte. Die gees van die Heere, Heere is op my, omdat hy my gesalf het om 'n blye boodskap te bring aan die ootmoediges. Hy het my gestuur om te verbind die gebrokenes van hart, om vir die gevangenes 'n vrylating uit te roep, en vir die geboeides opening van die gevangenes, om uit te roep 'n jaar van die welbehaag van die Heere, en 'n dag van die wraak van onze God, om al die treurendes te troos, om vir die treurendes in Sion te beskik, dat aan hulle gegee word sieraad vir as, vreugdeolie vir treurigheid, 'n gewaad van lof vir 'n verslae gees, sodat hulle genoem kan word terebinde van geregtigheid, 'n planting van die Heere tot sy verheerliking. En hulle sal die ou pynhope bou, die verwoeste plekke uit vroeër dae weer oprig, en die verwoeste stede weer nuut maak, wat woes was van geslag tot geslag. Geliefdes, dis die woord van God, die onfeilbare woord, die woord wat sewemaal gelouter is. Prys die naam van die Heere. Die Heere sê in sy woord dat alles sal verbygaan, maar sy woord sal vir ewig bly staan. Die Bybel sê dit is 'n betroubare woord, en dit is werd om ten volle aangeneem te word. Geliefde kinders van die Heere, soos ek in die begin gesê het, dit is 'n woeste jaar gewees, 'n jaar waar ons geweldige uitdagings gehad het, Binnen en buiten die kerk, binnen en buiten ons gemeenskap. Die hele wereld is lam geleden en is plat geslaan. Als gevolg, prijs die Heere, van hierdie virus wat ongekend voor ons generatie is. Maar die Heere het ons weer eens bewys dat hij is een God wat wakker is achter zijn woord. Hij zal nooit iets zeggen en het niet doen nie. Die Bijbel sê in sy woord dat hij is niet een mens dat hij zo lieg, of een mens een kind dat hij terug zal gaan op zijn woord. En dus in this morning, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you this morning through this word that the Lord laid on my heart this morning. The book of Isaiah is a very profound book in a sense that God, in the first 39 chapters of this book, God announces, praise the name of Jesus, that God is going to punish his children Israel for their sins. Hallelujah. God is about to punish them for what they did wrong against his laws. And the first 39 chapters, the prophet Isaiah explains to them the plan of God and what is about to happen, and all about the exile that is imminent and that will happen. Hallelujah, praise the name of Jesus. But the last bit of this book, the prophet Isaiah speaks to him, to them, and he tells them that there will be a remnant. There will be people coming back to the city. There will be people that God will save and bring back. God will not only think of punishment, hallelujah, and of judgment, but God also thinks, hallelujah, of restoration and another chance and bringing back and just saving his people out of captivity. Now the Bible teaches me in this particular portion of scripture, Isaiah speaks about God's plan through his Holy Spirit, how he's about to do things after, praise the Lord, the name of Jesus, after the exile. En geliefdes kinders van die Here, ons lees selfs toe Jesus in die tempel kom, praise die Here, en die boekrol aan hom gegee word, was dit juist die tyd toe hy hierdie gedeelte in die skrif gelees het, dat die gees van die Here is op hom. Dat is Jesus self wat hierdie woorde in vervulling gebring het, toe hy self gelees het en gesê dat die gees van die Here is op hom. Halleluja, en het hom gesalf, prys die naam van die Here, om die blye boodskap te bring. En vanmôre, kinders van die Here, is het asof Jesus met hierdie generasie praat en vir hom sê, alhoewel hy teruggegaan het hemel toe, en alhoewel hy, prys die Here, nie meer op die aarde is nie, het hy sy gees gestuur, en die gees van die waarheid, die gees van die Vader, wat ons lei in alle waarheid, en in die tyd. Hy sê vir sy disciples, prys die naam van die Here, dit is vir julle beter dat ek teruggaan, want as ek gegaan het, dan gaan ek julle die trooster stuur, wat julle sal lei in alle waarheid. En ek geloof vanmôre, dat dit is die tyd wanneer die kerk se lig moet skyn, want net soos die gees van die Here op Jesus was, net soos die gees van die Here op sy profete en op sy apostels was, so is die gees van die Here op sy kerk vandag. Ons het 'n blye boodskap, prys die Here. We do have a message, praise the name of Jesus, because he has anointed us. Praise the Lord, and he has sent us to heal the brokenhearted. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah 61:1 that God sent us to heal the brokenhearted. There is so many people's heart that has been broken. In fact, I do know and I do believe that there's no one on earth whose heart has never been broken. We've experienced brokenheartedness, all of us. Hallelujah, has for some times in our lives, maybe you were young or maybe you became old, and there were people that broke your heart, people who disappointed us, and the gospel of Jesus Christ has been sent to this world to preach the good tidings, the good message of hope that God will heal our broken hearts. I am here this morning, brothers and sisters, to remind us this word that Jesus spoke to us, that the Spirit of God is upon us. The Spirit of God is upon the church. And we have a message of hope this morning, that God will wipe all our tears away. God is going to heal our hearts. Hearts that has been disappointed. Hearts that has been broken. God's gospel, the gospel of truth, the gospel of Jesus Christ is the message of hope to this nation, a message of hope to this generation. Listen to the word of God. He goes further and he says, we must proclaim liberty to the captives. Oh my God, this year has been a year where many, many of us felt captive. We felt that we were bound. And I do believe that the message of the gospel has the ability and the authority and the power to heal us. Not only heal us, but also to free us. Praise the name of Jesus. There's many of us this morning that needs to be loosened. Loosened from this grip of corona. Loosened from the grip of poverty. Loosened from the grip, hallelujah, of this world. But I do believe that there is a need helper, and his name is Jesus, and he can help us and he can free us. He goes further in the first verse and he says, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound. I do believe this is a season, an imminent season, a season coming upon us where the Spirit of God will be so much, hallelujah, that the world must acknowledge that Jesus is alive, that God is in control, and that the Spirit of God is working in and around and through his church. We are here this morning, and I'm here this morning to proclaim liberty to the captives. I don't care this morning what is keeping you from being freed, but I do believe this morning that there is hope. I do believe that there is power available. I do believe that Jesus, through his grace, is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, far more than we preach or teach or even pray for. And this morning, I want to remind us all, hallelujah, that a prison is a place of restriction, a place of limitation, but God is able to do it. God is able to free us. God is able to help us, just like he promised Israel through the prophet of Isaiah, that you will be going into exile. You will experience the judgment of God because of his love and his grace, but also we now experience the wrath of God. We can see the judgments of God over the nations. But God is not only a God who loves, but he also judges. But he does not only judge, but he also restores. And he also returns a remnant. And this morning I want to encourage you, keep faith. Keep the hope up. I don't care if you are in a bed this morning, hallelujah, under the machines of the hospital. I do not care what your situations are this morning. The only thing that I hope for is that you will reach out to Jesus, because he can help us this morning, because he said we must proclaim liberty to the captives. Listen to the word of God. He says, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound. It might seem as the enemy who has come to steal and to rob off of our joy, came to rob off of our life. It might seem as if he is winning this battle, but let me remind you this morning that God is never late. God is always on time. He might not be in your time and in my time, but he's always in time, and he's about to open prisons. Prisons of hopelessness. God is about to restore us. Keep the faith, my brother. Keep the faith, my sister. Irrespective, hallelujah, what the number says of the machines in the hospital, keep the faith, because God is about to open prisons in hospitals this morning. The verse 2, the Bible says, we must proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. Praise the Lord. 2020 does not feel as an acceptable year. Ja, die baris, hierdie 2020 voel nie, prijs die Heere, asof dit een jaar van welbeha is nie. Maar ten spuite van alles wat gebeur het, ten spuite van alles wat gebeur het, is ons nog steeds vanochtend hier. Halleluja, ons kan nog steeds vanmorgen vraag, dood, waar is jou angel? Doderheid, waar is jouw kracht? Ons kan nog steeds vanmorgen sê, halleluja, dat niks kan ons skei van die liefde van die Here nie. Ons kan nog vanmorgen nog steeds sê, halleluja, dat alles werkt ten goede mee vir hulle wat God lief het, vir hulle wat na sy voorneme geroep het. Ja, 2020 does not feel as if it is an acceptable year, but this year is not finished yet, and I do believe that the day of vengeance of our God is at hand. I do believe that God is gonna break through, and God is gonna help us. God is gonna restore our nation. God is gonna restore our churches. God is gonna restore our families, irrespective, hallelujah, what happened through this year. God is about to do something great. Hallelujah, this year is not finished yet. My brothers and my sister, this year is not finished yet. I do believe that this is the acceptable year of the Lord. The Bible says in the second verse of Isaiah chapter 61, he says, we are here to proclaim not only the acceptable year, but we are here to comfort those who are mourning. Hallelujah, someone who mourns is someone who lost. And yes, we have lost so many things this year. People have lost their jobs. Some have lost their family members. Some have lost their love, their partners. Someone lost their wife or their husband, their sister or their brother. But let me remind you this morning, beautiful children of God, let me remind you this morning, the Bible says in the second verse, the B section, to console those who mourn in Zion. Let me tell you this morning, Zion represents the city of David. Hallelujah, the people of God, those people who decided to live in line with the word of God, those who decided to do the will of God. It speaks about people who decided, hallelujah, to follow the message of God and who decided to follow Jesus as their Savior. And sometimes we tend to think that all things will always stay summer. But let me remind you this morning that irrespective of whether we are born again or saved, there will come times in our life where we go through the fire and where we go through the deep waters. But the promise of God is that He will never leave us alone. He will never abandon us. I am here to console those who mourn in Zion, who feel that they are believers, but they lost so many things during this year. They lost maybe their health or their jobs. But let me remind you this morning, a promise from God, that God is about, hallelujah, to give you beauty for ashes. Praise the name of Jesus. What a powerful promise. The word beauty in Hebrew speaks about a dressing on your head. And it can represent, praise the Lord, what is happening in our minds. You know, when we go through difficult times, difficult seasons in our life, when we go through difficult moments, moments that we cannot always feel that we are in control, hallelujah, name of Jesus, hallelujah, we go through trials and tribulations, hallelujah, I want to remind you this morning about this beautiful word called beauty, because God is about to change our ashes into beauty. So beauty, it represents what is put on our head, hallelujah, and I want to tell us this morning, God wants us to know, hallelujah, that sometimes when we go through these difficult seasons, we don't always understand. God is the beginning and He's the end. Sometimes we trust Him in the beginning and we rejoice in the end, but we are in confusion mode in the middle of the story. But let me tell you this morning that God does not always tell us what is the middle side of your story, like He did with Abram. He said Abram must move from his father's house to the promised land. But God did not tell him all the difficult times that will come. Just like Moses and Joseph, hallelujah, all these beautiful beginnings. And we do not always understand what happens in the middle of the story. But let me tell you this morning, praise the Lord, looking back into my own life, I also experienced mourning. I also experienced loss. I also experienced many times that people did not recognize or acknowledge me or given me an opportunity. But looking back into my life where I am now today, I thank God for the people who rejected me. I thank God for those who neglected me. I thank those who turned their back on me, because God is a God who changes the ashes into beauty. And let me remind you this morning, hallelujah, that when we come through this and when we go through this, we will only then realize that God used whatever happened to build us up and to get us to where we need to be. Look at David, look at Moses, hallelujah, look at Joseph's life, look at Jesus' life, how, what a wonderful romantic beginning Jesus had, and look how it ended, and how it went, and how we were rejected. But God said it is not over until he says it's over. On the third day he rose again, and God changed his ashes into beauty. So God is going to give us a new mindset. A new mindset when we went through this difficult times. God is going to make us realize that he is able and he is willing and he is ready to do this, that he will change our ashes into beauty. You know, ashes speaks about the things that remains after destruction. And this year was a year where there were so many destructions. But God is going to take whatever is left behind, and God is going to change it into beauty. May God bless us this morning. I want to end off this morning by giving the last bit of this verse. He says, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Yes, we are feeling really heavy in spirit. So many people, they feel a burden in their life and in their spirit. This is a tough year. The enemy has really rattled us this year. Our faith has been tested. But God instructs us to put on a garment of praise. You know, a garment is not something that is just there. There needs to be an effort from you yourself, from me myself, to put on this garment of praise every day. Irrespective of what is happening, irrespective of whether we are sick, irrespective of whether we have lost our jobs, irrespective of whether our family members are in hospital, God instructs us always to put on our garments of praise. You know, because God stays in the presence of praise. God inhabits the praises of his people. The Bible says it is through our praises that God feels welcome in our midst. So may the Lord bless us this morning. May the Lord really bless us as a church. May the Lord really use us this time as the body of God, of Christ, to recognize and to realize that the Spirit of God is upon us, and we are here and we are anointed to preach the good news. God bless you. May God continue blessing you, healing you, saving you. And I'll be back on Tuesday night, and I will be doing a program called Walk Through the Bible, and we are going to do 15 to half an hour biblical study for the next few weeks. As we are in rest at our church here in Caledon. And God bless all Church of God people, and may the Lord use this word to encourage you this morning. Amen.